Welcome to RP Hub. In this video, we'll show you how we can collect different cities' temperature and humidity by using UiPath, which is an RPA-based tool where we can collect the temperature and humidity from the Google and capture it or save it into the Excel file. So, if you want to learn RP content, please follow my different playlists created for UiPath and Power Automate. You can also find it out several other contents related to the RPA. For this video, we can proceed ahead with capturing or extracting the temperature and humidity of different city using UiPath. So let me run this code and show you how we can fetch this detail and store into the Excel file. Post that I will delete everything and create it in front of you so that you will able to understand how we can perform this automation easily without writing a single line of code. So if you can see, this is an Excel file where we have stored locations, temperature and humidity. So we'll fetch all the city temperature one by one and store into the Excel file. So execution has been started and this will go one by one, collect the information and save it to Excel. Now you can see one by one this is going and filtering out the detail and storing into the Excel. Now you can see all the cities details are done where we have captured all this temperature and stored into the Excel file. Now let me delete the complete flow and then we will build it in front of you so that we can capture these details quickly. Now here, let me create a new sequence and give the name as climate use case. Now next activity, we'll drag and drop access process scope. Inside the Excel process scope, we will store the Excel data one by one after execution. Next activity, I will drag and drop use Excel file where I will specify the Excel file location with the path. So as of now, we have stored this temperature data Excel into the same folder. So that's the reason we don't have to specify the path. Just we can give the name with extension file name. Now reference as Excel. And we'll give here the sheet name. So climate Excel is my sheet name. And as of now, I've unchecked save changes. Post that, we'll add new activity for each. So I'm dragging and dropping for each Excel row. And from here, let's specify current row. And in the range field, we have to specify the climate sheet indicated in Excel. Now you can see we have A1 to C11 is my range. So current sheet is confirmed. We had just have to click on confirm and then this will capture my sheet detail. Now next activity, I will drag and drop use application browser and here I will indicate the browser detail or location space from where we want to capture the data. So as of now, we are focusing on google.com. So this will navigate it to the google.com from where we will search the city detail. So open as an app. and browser will specify as Chrome. Next activity I will use type into. So in type into will enter the value of city. So it means this will fetch the city name from Excel and fill it into Google. So as of now, we are selecting for the selector and validation score we have to specify it so that we can get accurate output. Apart of that, we have to also current row, locations, and then address. And we can also give empty field before typing as well as click on enter. Next activity we'll use here. So after that we'll use get text activity, and from get text activity we'll extract the temperature and humidity of every city. Now we'll store this into variable as temperature. And next get text activity will use it for humidity detail. So percentage of humidity we are capturing here. Again, we'll store this into a variable humidity. And next, we'll use write cell activity to write each of the value into the Excel file. So first, we'll specify string temperature with the range, specified range. And after that, we'll also use write cell for humidity. When we'll click on the indicator in Excel, this will open Excel file to be indicated. So we just have to select the positions and then click on confirm, and it will very much easy to confirm the order. So this will capture cell detail. Next, write cell activity we are using for humidity. Again, we'll use same step for performing the range. Next activity will drag and drop as message box, and here will show successful message. So each write activity, after each write activity, will get this done successfully. So now we are done. Let's save it and run the process. We'll see exactly same result how we have seen earlier. So that's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. And for learning more content, keep following the channel. Thank you for watching.